Welcome back to our corner internet. Okay, so tonight I'm back at it with the Vanity Fair lie detector test again. Okay, this time reacting to David Dobrik taking a lie detector test with Vanity Fair. Looky here, it's been a while since I had David Dobrik's name. And he's been kind of a blessing, truly. Truly, because last thing we want to hear is that he was controlling another excavator and injured another friend of his. Yeah. Okay, so that's what we're doing. I'm about to react to David Dobrik taking a lie detector. Oh, don't know I'm dating anyone.
No,
I know this one's quite old. Cause they're no longer dating anyone.
I'm so sorry.
That's okay.
Just saying.
That's you, not your girlfriend, correct?
Nah.
Okay.
Son of a bitch.
So first, we'll talk about your life.
Okay.
You nervous?
No. Yes, I am.
You were born in Slovakia.
Yes.
Do you remember living there?
Yes.
What do you remember?
I remember living in an apartment. I remember my grandma. I remember my grandpa's hair. He had a lot of it for his age. And I remember I used to have two bunnies. And then when I moved, my aunt and uncle ate them. This is serious.
Hmm?
They're gone now.
Why did they eat them?
That's just how they work in Slovakia. You don't really keep bunnies as pets, but I did.
Are you sad when your family ate your pets?
No.
When did you move to Chicago?
In the fourth grade. The suburbs.
Would you call yourself a Chicagoan?
Yes. In front of other people that have never been to Chicago, I would. But if I meet someone from Chicago, I make sure to let them know that I'm not from Chicago, or else they'll be mad.
Is there something you miss most about living in Chicago?
Yes. My hometown friends.
He's telling the truth.
Whoa. Hello.
You're a DACA recipient, right?
Yes.
Are you worried about your status under Trump?
Yes.
How so?
I'm worried in the I'm gonna start crying. In the way that I feel like I could get deported, but I'm also not worried because I just don't really think about it. But like if I think about it, then yeah, I'd be worried.
Next, let's talk about your friends. We asked one of your friends from high school to ask you some questions. Ready? Play the tape.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, he said.
How many times, David?
Three.
Just three times?
Yes, just three times.
Did you ever win anything in high school?
I won some things. What's it to you?
So you won things in high school? Would you win?
All state in tennis. Did you just laugh?
I'm not the one being examined here.
Did you laugh?
No.
Just everyone always seems to laugh when I say I play tennis.
Let's play the final question.
Who was your high school crush?
It's Courtney. This girl. I said it. She's a boyfriend now. Don't put this in there.
Courtney was your high school crush?
Yeah.
Did you ever ask her out?
No.
Why not?
Because I'm a little bitch.
Do you still talk to her? slide into her DMs?
No. She has a boyfriend.
He's a god.
Is this man, Scotty Sire, your best friend?
No. Listen, if you're just gonna show me pictures of my friends and ask who the best friend one is, I'm out. But show me another.
Would you say Toddie Smith is your best friend?
No. Neither of them are my best friends.
It's probably Jason Nash.
John, does that check out?
Ah, shit. Don't post this anywhere, please.
Do you know how you would rank your vlog squad from best to worst friend?
Mm-hmm. No. I don't know.
Come on, David. Give it your best shot.
Mm-hmm. Number one? I'd have to go with Jason. Number two, I have to go with Todd. Number three, Scott. Number four, Carly. Number five, Aaron.
Why are you doing Aaron like that?
That's none of your business.
Are you aware that a lot of people in your comments call you cute?
I am aware.
Yeah, why?
Would you call yourself cute?
Yes.
You know, say beauty in the eye of the beholder.
Yes.
He's not ugly, though.
Are you cuter than Cameron Dallas?
Hell no.
How cute would you say he is on a scale of 1 to 10?
If I'm a 6, he's an 8.5.
I'd give you a 5, David, but...
I think I'm... I think 5 would be average. But I think... when I do my hair the right way, I get up to a 6.
You okay there, David?
Can I go home?
No. Would you say you find this man, Drake Bell, more attractive than this man, Josh Peck?
No, I would not say that.
So, who's more attractive?
My type? Josh Peck. He's a husband now, and he has a family, and he's a child. The type of person I would want to be with.
And now, let's talk about relationships. You single now?
Yes.
But you previously were in a 2-year relationship with one Liza Koshy?
Yes.
Are you aware that your breakup announcement was your most viewed video on YouTube?
Yes.
Was it really?
How does that make you feel?
Surprised. No, not surprised.
These are
pretty
these
solid.
Are
that
love
that people supporting us. It's more a good thing than a bad thing.
Is it true that she broke up with you?
Yes. Man.
Are you sad that it's over?
Yes.
Are you actively trying to get her back?
No.
Somehow I don't believe you.
You dating anyone else right now?
No.
You okay?
Huh? Yeah, I'm good. No, I'm good. You guys have tissues?
Let's move on to your career. Do you miss your privacy?
No.
Really?
For some things, but no. If it would cost me my job, then no. It's nice to have some privacy.
What do you miss most about your privacy?
Just people not knowing the ins and outs of everything in my life. Not knowing everything that's going on. That was kind of nice, but it doesn't matter.
You regularly watch your own videos in your free time?
No.
But do you read the comments?
Yes.
In general, how do you feel about the comments?
Most of the time, pretty good.
You ever engage trolls?
Sometimes. No, not really, no.
So that's a no?
No.
So, no meaning you don't engage with trolls? Or no meaning you do engage with trolls?
Exactly. Took the words right out of my mouth.
Okay. Okay. What's the worst comment that you've ever read?
Not worst, but I get a lot of, like, I get a lot of comments that say he's attractive in, like, a weird way. Or, like, I don't know if I'm the only one, but I'm weirdly attracted to him. It's kind of like a backhanded compliment. It's not the worst, but it's like, why are you saying that?
Are you happy now?
Yes.
Are you still happy now?
Yes, I am.
Some people on Reddit speculate that you make a lot of your videos 420 in length because of 420.
Yes.
So, you smoke weed?
No.
David?
A little bit.
He does.
I'll smoke like once every like 6 months.
How high are you right now?
The question.
How high are you right now?
Super high. I'm not high right now, I'm sober.
Okay. Let's talk about YouTube. You started off on Vine, correct?
Correct.
Do you have a favorite Vine that you made?
No.
If you had to pick one, is there one you like?
Yeah, I like most of them.
Well, which one did you like the most?
I'm drawing a blank on them. I mean, I can explain it to you, but it would just bore you.
Wouldn't you call the one you like the most your favorite?
Yes.
So you do have a favorite Vine?
Yeah.
You just can't explain it to us now, or?
No.
Okay. We'll move on then. Was there a Vine made by someone else that you wish you'd thought of?
Yeah.
Oh, I miss Vine, actually.
I really like the one where it Vine. Goes, where it's that song, and I go, dun, 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 and then this girl turns around, her name's Chloe, and she has, like, glasses on, and she makes a funny face. Do you know what I'm talking about? See, this is why I don't explain why.
That sounds very funny.
Thank you.
Are there any YouTubers that you think are sellouts?
Yes.
Can you name one?
Sure. Zayn and Jazzy.
What about this guy?
Yes. Major sellout. The biggest.
If you were to describe this man with a single word, it would be...
You said it perfect for yourself. Sellout.
So, I think that's two words.
Shit. Pretty high.
Maybe try an edible for this video.
One of your vlogs, you jumped into 1,400 pounds of dry ice. Is that right?
14,000.
Tell the truth here, David. Is it a bit hacky when YouTubers watch and react to their own videos?
Yeah, it is. But I know what you're gonna do.
What am I gonna do?
You're gonna show me a picture of me reacting to my own video? Okay.
Oh, is that something you've done?
No, I've never done it.
Yeah. Probably.
So you have reacted to your own videos before?
No.
Okay. So...
I have. I've reacted to my own videos. I have.
And that's coming out again.
You're saying that's a hack move?
Yeah.
But you're calling yourself a hack?
No. I just got nervous.
Are there lots of people out there copying your videos?
Yes.
Taking notice of anyone? Or?
No.
Is copying somebody else's video wrong?
Not necessarily.
In what way?
If you give it your own twist.
Are there any YouTubers out there who you think are funnier than you?
Yes.
Like who?
want to keep that a secret.
What about this person?
She is. She's funny.
And how about the Dolan twins? Are they funnier than you?
Yes.
By a lot, or just a little?
Just a little. I don't know.
Do you think you'll ever be funnier than these guys?
I'm working my way up there.
You have a plan to elevate your game?
Work out more.
How much can you bench?
Enough. Can we cut the interview?
I don't think so, David. You should fine. Make a comeback.
No.
Why not?
Because it was like a cool thing for like a group of people to enjoy, and that's it. Like it was hot when it was hot, and that's it. We shouldn't revisit it. It's like making a sequel to a great movie. Why? Just watch the movie again.
All right, David. Last question. At any point during this interview, did you lie and we didn't catch it?
No.
Probably.
I'm going to ask you again. At any point during this interview, did you lie and we didn't catch it?
No.
He said that. Some people, man. Some people can light their teeth and get away with it. Some people can't. You mean? You can get the people that are good at lying and the ones that aren't. But I know some people who are shit at lying, so it's actually quite funny watching them try and lie, because we just stand down and they start singing like a canary. It's fucking hilarious. Like, no joke. I have so many friends, I don't know whether it's the same one that should keep it secret or the one, or a different one. I'm joking, I know who it is. Oh man. But that'd be so funny, just hook up all mates to lie to the test. And it'd be, like I just want to do it, hook them all up to lie detectors and ask them these questions which they're gonna try and dodge, they've been trying to dodge for ages, and it's so fun. I think it'd be hilarious. I don't think that'll ever happen though, mind you, because, you know, they're very private. Yeah, put a paper bag over their heads, and then maybe they might be more inclined. This sounds like it though. It was funny trying to watch him try and lie. I bet if any of my friends hooked me up to a lie detector, they would all questions which I don't want to answer. And it's like once it's good, that's probably gonna make me squirm. And it's like, nah. It's one of the ones that's like, I wish you wouldn't ask me that one. And because I'm hooked up to the light, I can't, like, plead the fifth, can I? These have too much shit on me. What can I say? So. But, yeah, I'm done here. It was on the right light detector. It would. So, yeah. Decent video. And I gotta head off. So yeah, I'm done here. Okay, so that's it for this video. Like, subscribe if you want. I post if whenever I feel like it, and I'll see you next one. Bye.